they took him to Cook County Jail, which is a god-awful place. And it was traumatic, you know, to see, you know, someone that you looked at, you know, as a powerful force being you know, stripped away of his freedom, right in front of you. Anyway, little did I know, about 5 years later, in true father-son, I ended up going to Cook County Jail myself. And, you know, I guess I, you know, like, you become your parents whether you want to or not, I guess, in some way. And, but we weren't there at the same time, fortunately. That was good. That would have been weird. So, anyway, he had this, you know, as he got older, he had this picture window that he would always watch everybody in the neighborhood from. And when I was younger and I would go to Leeds, he'd always be kind of like watching me, and I resented it, really, because I thought he was just being suspicious or whatever. So, anyway, after my mom died first, and then he died shortly thereafter, and I went back to the house to go through it one last time, you know, and knew nobody was there. I pulled into the driveway, and I saw for the first time in my life. Been at that house my whole life, and it was the first time I was able to see into the house. It was a cold January day, and it was really beautiful, and it was really sad, though, you know, that he was that figure that I kind of resented for a long time, and then now, on this particular day, I was missed it greatly. And so anyway, I wrote this for him, and it's called Shadow of the Moon. So I took a drive over to his house. No one knew he wasn't there. He was always standing looking out that window, or sitting in his easy chair. He was always a bit of a mystery, always seemed so far away. Even when he was standing next to me, we never had that much to say. He would always hear me coming home from a million miles away. And I'd see his silhouette in the window every time I pulled out of the drive.
I see it happen. Yeah, he told so many stories. I was never sure which ones were true. Yeah, but he was too big for the small town. He was an Irishman through and through. And the bagpipes moaned on that cold day, the day we laid him to rest. But all I can say is I drive away. Pop, I'm sorry, can't tell it. Now there's a shadow in the window that's missing. There's a shadow in the window that's gone. I only want to tell you I love you. And I'm sorry that things went so wrong. And maybe I'll see you in heaven. At least that's how the story goes.
Yo!